Liberty Process.
This is an instructional disassembly video for the Liberty Process Equipment APM22 Close Coupled Progressive Cavity Pump. This pump is sometimes called a Wobble Stator pump. The same pump disassembly procedures are also used for Liberty Process APM pump sizes 15, 33, and 44. For pump sizes APM 56 and APM 67, please refer to those specific pump disassembly videos and instruction manuals. Here we will fully demonstrate the complete disassembly of the APM22 progressing cavity pump. While repairing, disassembling, or installing the pump, we recommend using the Operations, Maintenance, and Installations Manual for the Liberty AP and APM series pumps and reviewing them before starting any repairs. These are available for view or downloadable at www.libertyprocess.com. These manuals contain the full information on how to properly assemble and disassemble and how to safely operate your Liberty Progressive Cavity APM Series Wobble Stator pump. Before we begin, if the pump has been used, we recommend that you have flushed and drained the pump of all pump mediums and have a clean repair service on which to work. Tools required for the APM22 pump disassembly: a flathead screwdriver, a 9/16 inch wrench for pump motor mounting bolts, a half inch wrench for the drain plug, 2 7/16 inch wrenches for the pump casing bolts, a 3/16 inch Allen wrench for flex joint removal, and a 7/64 inch Allen wrench for stub shaft set screws. Disassembly of the APM22 progressing cavity pump. For ease of disassembly, stand pump on motor end and secure on a workbench. Remove the drain plug using a half inch wrench. Using the pair of 7/16 inch wrenches, begin by removing the pump foot bolts and remove the pump mounting foot if one is installed. Then remove the rest of the 6 bolts on the suction and discharge casings. Once the 6 pump casing bolts are removed, you can lift the suction casing off the pump, exposing the pump stator. Using both hands, remove the pump stator from the pump by lifting it vertically off the pump rotor. The pump rotor, flex joint, and shaft mechanical seal will now be exposed. Insert the 7/64 inch Allen wrench to use as leverage to lock the stub shaft for ease of removing the pump rotor. Unscrew the rotor counterclockwise from the flex joint. Leaving the 7/64 inch Allen wrench in the stub shaft, use the 3/16 inch Allen wrench and place it into the top of the pump flex joint. Turn counterclockwise to remove the flex joint from the pump stub shaft. Remove the spring and rotating face of the mechanical seal assembly from the stub shaft. The stationary face of the seal assembly will still be installed in the pump discharge casing. Using the 9/16 inch wrench, unscrew the 4 bolts on the pump discharge casing from the motor mounting flange and lift the discharge casing off the motor. To remove the stationary face of the mechanical seal from the pump discharge casing, turn the pump discharge casing over. Using your fingers, press out the stationary face of the mechanical seal. If it remains stuck, use a flat-bladed screwdriver to gently pry it loose. Loosen and remove the two set screws from the pump stub shaft. Remove the pump stub shaft from the motor shaft. You have now completely disassembled your Liberty APM22 Wobble Stator pump. Assembly of the APM22 pump. Make sure the pump motor is on the table and secure. Place the pump stub shaft on the motor shaft and seat. Tighten with 7/64 inch hex keys. Lubricate the outer diameter of the seal stationary face with liquid soap. Using your thumbs, gently press the stationary face of the seal into the discharge casing until it seats. Install the discharge casing onto the motor, taking care not to damage the seal on the stub shaft. Tighten the discharge casing onto the motor using the 4 9/16 inch bolts. Install the rotating face of the mechanical seal onto the stub shaft by lubricating the stationary face of the mechanical seal, then sliding the rotating face onto the stub shaft. Now, place the rotating face and spring assembly over the stub shaft. Thread the flex joint into the rotor. Place the 7/64 inch hex key into the hex nut on the stub shaft to hold it in place. You may now thread the flex joint and rotor into the stub shaft. Lubricate the rotor and interior of the stator with liquid hand soap. Slide the stator, open side down, onto the rotor and push down. The stator will seat itself into the channel on the discharge casing and will act as a seal. Install the suction casing onto the pump assembly. Bolt the suction casing down using the 7/16 inch bolts, saving the two largest bolts for the foot assembly. Add the pump foot assembly to the bottom of the pump for support. Use the two largest screws to secure. Bolt down the casing till seated. Add the pump drain plug using a half-inch wrench. Your pump is now complete and should be leak tested using water to check the seal for leakage. If no leaks are present, the pump can now be reinstalled into the pump system. Feel free to celebrate accordingly. If you have any questions about or require spare parts for the repair of your Liberty Process APM pump, please contact us at www.libertyprocess.com. We always have complete pumps and all spare parts in our inventory ready to ship the same day.